Welcome to TechnoSaiyajan YouTube channel. So today we had a leak, kind of a leak by video cards which states that some Intel B660 motherboards but like PCJ Express Gen 5 support, which we know for don't know because in the blog diagram it said that PCH Express 5.2 will be supported by older lake, but it is not true as most of the motherboards will not support PCH Express 5.0. 5.0 will bring us 128 GB per second memory capacity, but it is not supported. Moving on, we have like the trade by Gremon 55, which is a relevant tweaker, and he leaked that AD105-102 at a Loveless by NVIDIA will have 5 nanometer TSMC fabrication. 144 stream processor, which equates to 18,432 CUDA cores. On a 384-bit bus, 24 GB GDDR6X memory with 21 gigabits per second, 2.3 to 2.5 gigahertz, and 85 to 92 FP32 performance. And for driving that, I think on top of that, Copper Kimi commented that the next-gen GPUs might require a new PSU, which we know for sure from the last few weeks that there might be. If we are going to follow the new GPUs in the future, we might need a new CPU, new PSU. And it has also leaked that it is going to be launching in Q3 of 2022, which is the planned release date, but we don't know for sure whether it will happen or not. Moving on, AMD has recently announced its MCM GPU, and we can see from this show that it is a one heck of a GPU, the MCM architecture, but Gremon 55 has tweeted that N31, which makes like the upper range of the 7900 XT, will have an MCM architecture which will be based on the RDNA 3 architecture, and it's on an advanced node, most preferably 5 nanometers, but it states that it's going to be around 5 nanometers, 5 and 6 nanometers, so 6 nanometers is going to be for 4C architecture, 4C GPU, while it says that it supports GFX 11 120 GWGP, which equates to 15,360 stream processors on a 256-bit bus, 32 GB of RAM, GDDR6, 18 gigabits per second, 256 MB of 512 MB Infinity Cache, which because it is an MCM GPU, 3D Infinity Cache, and various other things as stated above, but it's very soon to be sure. But this is going to be one heck of a GPU, and it's going to be launching in most preferably in the Q3 if this is true. And it says like it's got up to 75 teraflops of FP32 compute, which is totally insane. And make sure to watch for this GPU because I'm also looking forward to it. As always, time will tell because currently the GPU market is saturated with scammers. So that's it for today, and I will see you in the next week, next video. Peace out.